Today is the day of Arafah. And the day of Arafah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that the day of Arafah and the day of Eid and the 3 days after that, they call Ayyam al-Tashriq. These 5 days, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is our Eid, people of Islam. Imagine the Prophet lumped some 5 days as Eid, which is amazing. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So, that's number one. So today's Eid, tomorrow's Eid, and the 3 days after that is Eid. Number two, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam witnessed a Eid on Friday. So he said to people, Allah has brought upon you two Eid, the Eid of Jum'ah and the Eid of Al-Adha. So, mashallah, Eidun after Eid, Nurun ala Nur. Number three, talking about the day of Arafah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no day more likely that Allah will forgive someone and spare him from hellfire like the day of Arafah. There's no day more likely Allah will spare someone from hell and give him his absolute amnesty and forgiveness like the day of Arafah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that no dua in the whole year is like the dua of the day of Arafah. So it's the most. And nothing in the same hadith, and nothing that I said, me and the prophets before me, better than La ilaha illallah. MashaAllah. The day of Arafah is the day in which the ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah number 5, ayah number 3, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have completed your religion for you, and I have perfected my blessing upon you, and I'm pleased, and I accept that Islam is your deen. I am pleased as with Islam is your deen. Allah is pleased with Islam is our deen. So are you pleased? Are you happy with Islam the way it is? So inshallah you are. This is called rida bima yarda Allah, to accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted. My dear brothers and sisters, you might think, Sheikh, you're talking about the day of Arafah at the end of the day of Arafah. Why didn't you speak about it in the beginning? Well, here is some news for you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam considered that the day of Arafah will continue until Allahu Akbar of the day of Eid. So, for those amongst you who were working and who were busy today, and you think you feel so down, and you did not do enough dua, and you did not do enough Quran and dhikr and salah and this, it's not over yet. All days are over by Maghrib, and the next day starts after Maghrib, except the day of Arafah. Someone came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, I was traveling from my people on the back of my camel. I stood up on every mountain. I thought it was the mountain of Arafah. I kept on running from mountain to mountain and mountain until I passed by Arafah. And now I came and I prayed with you Fajr at Muzdalifah. Did I lose Hajj? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever witnessed Salat al-Fajr with us today, he has caught Arafah. Imagine, Salat al-Fajr, the next day, whosoever witnessed with us Salat al-Fajr, the next day, he has witnessed Arafah. So if that is for the Hujjaj, in which Rasulullah said, Al-Hajj Arafah, the most important day in Hajj is Arafah. If the one who goes to Hajj has all the way up to Salat al-Fajr of the next day, imagine the one who didn't go to Hajj. So I'm really, really, really excited. Yesterday night, mashallah, was Arafah in Mecca, but Arafah continues. Today is our Arafah, and it still carries the same value, and it carries the same value all the way till Salat al-Fajr. So, congratulations. May Allah Azza wa Jal accept from us. My dear brothers and sisters, this is a day that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah forgives 2 years with it, a year before and a year after. This is called time travel machine. You can go in the past and change the past 1 year, and you can go in the future and change the future by 1 year, all by fasting one day, which is the day of Arafah. And by the way, if you couldn't fast today because you're pregnant or breastfeeding or you have your period or you're sick or you have chronic disease or you're old or you're too young or your health doesn't help you or you were traveling, and you say, Ya Allah, if I wasn't going through that, I would have fasted today, Allah would write you and give you the entire, complete reward as if you fasted today. You will not miss anything. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, let's make dua. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, you know, Ya Allah, we say Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Ya Allah, in this blessed day, Ya Allah, we confess to you our weakness. Ya Allah, we don't complain about anything. We have zero complaints. The only complaint that we have is about our nafs and our ego and our pride. Ya Allah, the only complaint we have is about shaitan. Ya Allah, the only complaint we have is about the temptation of life. But Ya Allah, about you, you've given us every blessing that we are enjoying. Ya Allah, we confess to you our weakness. We confess to you our helplessness. We confess to you our hopelessness. We confess to you our lousiness in performing ibadah. Ya Allah, what we do is not enough. Ya Allah, when we pray, we don't focus. Ya Allah, when we fast, we don't focus. Ya Allah, when we give charity, we don't give enough. Ya Allah, we're plagued with sicknesses upon sicknesses. Ya Allah, we are not proud of anything, Ya Allah. But Ya Allah, even if we confess to you all of these things, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, Ya Allah, we have never built hope on ourselves or our strengths. We have never built hope on our deeds. We have never built hope on our actions. But Ya Allah, we build hope. We've built hope on your forgiveness. Ya Allah, we ask for your forgiveness. We ask you. We have hope because you are the forgiving. We have hope because you are the merciful. We have hope because you are the cherisher, the giving, the generous one. We have hope because you forgive. You are hope because you accept the repentance. We have hope because you strengthen the weak and you forgive the mistakes and you accept the repentance, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, other than that, we've come to you with nothing. Ya Allah, we confess our weakness, Ya Rabbal Alameen. But Ya Rabbal Alameen, we are strong. Why? Because you are our God. Because you are our Lord. Ya Rabbal Alameen, we have hope because you are our God and you save and guide and strengthen the believers. Ya Allah, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Ya Allah, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Ya Allah, you only we worship and you only we ask help. And Ya Allah, guide us to the straight path. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Ya Allah, we have no other God than you, Ya Rabbal Alameen, so that we would pray to. There is no God but you. So who are we going to pray to if you reject us? Who are we going to ask for his forgiveness if you do not accept us? Ya Allah, we have no Lord but you. You are our Lord and we are your slaves. You are our God and we are your worshippers and devotees. Ya Allah, please don't turn us away. Ya Allah, please don't shut down and don't shut off the door of forgiveness in our face, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, Ya Rabbal Alameen, our father Adam alayhi salam and our mother Hawa, when they ate from the tree and you asked them, why did you eat from the tree? You taught them to say words. They said, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Ya Allah, we have wronged ourselves. And if you're not merciful to us, and if you don't bestow your mercy upon us and forgive us, we will be amongst the losers. So you forgive them. Ya Allah, we make the same dua. We are the sons of Adam and the daughters of Hawa. We are their children and we make the same dua. رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Ya Allah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, Ya Akram al-Akrameen, Ya Arham al-Rahim. Ya Allah, when Yunus alayhi salam, Jonah, Ya Allah, when he got swallowed by the whale, he was in the darkness of the night, the darkness of the depth of the ocean, and the darkness of the belly of the whale, and he was getting digested in the stomach of the whale, but he said, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. After everything was done, and in any human calculation, he was gone. But Ya Allah, you taught us through your book that when you make dua, it's never too late. even when it looks too late, when it seems too late, when it seems it's over, it's not. Ya Allah, you made the whale. Spit him and throw him up on the ocean, on the shore of the ocean, and you made a tree of yaqteen grow upon him to cover him so that he can dry and repel insects from him. Subhanak ya Rabb. Ya Allah, we make the same dua that Yunus made. La ilaha illa subhanak inni kuntu min adh-dhalimin. So forgive us, ya Rabb al-alamin. Ya Allah, ya Rabb al-alamin. We make dua, the same dua that your son, your devotee, your Nabi and Prophet Yaqub made when he lost his son Yusuf. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. May Allah bring them back to me and gather them. Ya Allah, Yusuf alayhi salam, Ya Allah, he was thrown in the bottom of the well by his brothers, picked up and hidden as merchandise. He was sold as a slave. He served as a servant. And then when he refused haram, he was thrown at the bottom of the jail. But he said, إِنَّ رَبِّي سَمِيعُ الدُّعَاءِ. He said, رَبِّ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ يَا أَرْحَمَ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Ya Allah, we make the same dua that Yusuf alayhi salam made, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. When people wanted to go and crucify Isa alayhi salam, he made dua to you that you would save him. And you raised him up and you saved him from crucifixion. The same dua we make to you, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, when Ibrahim was tied with robes and they threw him in the fire, he said, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-Ali al-Azim. Hasbi Allah wa ni'ma al-Wakil. And Ya Allah, when it seemed so too late, when it seems he was going to be burning in that fire, you saved him and you made the fire cool upon him and safe for him, Ya Rabbal Alameen. We make the same dua, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, we make the same dua that Musa made. Rabbi inni lima anzalta ilayya min khayrin faqir. Ya Allah, for all the blessings that you've given me, I am poor and indebted to you. And I need it, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, Ya Rabbal Alameen, please, Ya Allah, with everything that we do that we're not supposed to do, and everything that we don't that we are supposed to do, Ya Allah, forgive us. Make this day a day of forgiveness, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Before the sunset of this day, Ya Allah, we ask you that you would have forgiven us all, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, we ask you to expand the rizq for everyone. Ya Allah, you have shown us your power and strength in the big things, in the galaxies, and in the small things, in the viruses. Ya Allah, we've learned a lesson. And we see, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, we see your power and strength. So Ya Allah, lift up this plague. Ya Allah, people lost their jobs. People that used to give charity now are in need of charity. People lost their face and their dignity, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. People are stressed. People are getting sick. People are dying. Ya Allah, we ask you that you lift this plague. And you make humanity a better humanity and you make the Muslims better Muslims. Ya Allah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, forgive all Muslims. Help us to pay off our debt and let Muslims pay off their debt. Ya Allah, any Muslim that is poor, make him rich. Any Muslim that is lost, bring him back to you, Ya Allah. Guide him, Ya Allah. Any Muslim that is in need of help, Ya Allah, help him. Any poor mother, and a mother that is an orphan, that her children are orphan and she cannot take care of them, Ya Allah, help her to take care of them, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, we thank you and we ask you, Ya Allah, to be there for the weak, for the old who has no one to take care of them, for the young who are malnutritioned. Ya Allah, bring peace to the Muslim world. Have peace and security in Syria, in Iraq, in Afghanistan, in Yemen, in Libya, in Egypt, in Morocco, in Tunisia, in Algeria, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. In everywhere there is a Muslim. Ya Allah, be there for our Muslims and brothers and sisters in Sudan, in Kenya, in Mozambique, in Tanzania, in all the Somalia, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, be there for our Muslims in West Africa, be it in Nigeria or Senegal or Ivory Coast. Ya Allah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Ya Allah, be there for every Muslim in every continent, whether they are in Pakistan or in India or in Bangladesh, whether they are in Singapore, Malaysia or Indonesia. Ya Allah, for all the Muslims, Ya Rabbal Alameen, make their life easy, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Allah, they are our brothers and sisters. We love for them what we love for ourselves. As you have given us, give them, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Give them love, give them power, give them security, give them income, give them food, give them shelter, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, make the world a better place for us and for our children. Ya Allah, help us and give us the knowledge and wisdom to raise our children, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Arhamar Rahimin, Ya Akram Al-Akramin. Ya Allah, we thank you for everything you've given us. You told us, if you're thankful, I will give you more. So we are thankful, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Please, Ya Allah, help us and support us, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Allah, help Muslims in America and in Canada and in Europe and in England and in every country, Ya Rabbal Alameen. In Australia, Ya Rabbal Alameen. In every Western country that there is a Muslim minority, or in any country that there is a Muslim minority, Ya Allah, I ask you to take care of this horrific test that our brothers, the Uyghurs, are going through, Ya Rabbal Alameen, in China. Ya Allah, please save them. Save them, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Be there for them, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, our brothers and sisters, in every country where they are suffering, whether they are in Turkey or in Iran or in any place where they are suffering and they are under siege and embargo and they are going through hardship, Ya Allah, give them security. Ya Allah, any leadership in the Muslim world that are bent into destroying Islam and Muslims, take it away from us. And any leadership that wants something good for Islam and Muslims, security and peace and love and equality, and bring back people to Allah, Ya Allah, help them and support them and be there for them. Ya Allah, we have munafiqeen that are from us. They carry our names, but they fight Islam and Muslims day and night. Ya Allah, take care of them. Take care of them. Take care of them like you took care of Al-Ahzab on the Battle of the Ditch. Rabbil Allahumma munzila Allahumma mujriya as-sahab wa munzila al-kitab wa hazima al-ahzab ihzimhum ya rabbal alamin wansur al-muslimina ala al-munafiqin Allahumma man arada bil islam wal muslimin, whosoever wants something bad for Islam and Muslims, Ya Allah, stop him in his track and take care of him, and whosoever wants something good for Islam and Muslims and for humanity, bring him forward and support him, Ya rabbal alamin. يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا الله, our brothers and sisters in the poor Muslim countries, in the highly populated Muslim countries, they are suffering on a large scale. In Indonesia, in Bangladesh, in India, Muslims are feel insecure. Ya Allah, in Pakistan, large Muslim countries, large Muslim ones. In Nigeria, Ya Allah, there are large, huge number of Muslims, hundreds of millions of Muslims. Ya Allah, be there for them. Give them the food. Give them the dignity, give them the power, the strength to carry their life, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, make the Quran the pleasure of our hearts. And make with the Quran all of our sadness, all of our worries, all of our grievances, all of our depression, all of our stress gone with the Quran. Ya Allah, make us from those who read the Quran, who understand the Quran, who implement the Quran, who call people to the Quran, who memorize the Quran. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, we thank you and we love you. Ya Allah, strengthen our iman. Make Islam look beautiful in our eyes, beloved to our hearts. Make kufr and fusuq and asyan look ugly in our eyes and hated to our hearts, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, guide us to the straight path. Forgive us and help us. Ya Arhamar Rahimin, Ya Akram Al-Akramin, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, we thank you. We thank you abundantly, Ya Rab. Ya Akram Al-Akramin, Ya Allah, guide the Muslim brothers and sisters, Ya Rabbal Alameen, all over the world. Ya Allah, bring peace between the husbands and wives. Ya Allah, bring peace between the parents and the children. Ya Allah, our children are getting between our hands. Ya Allah, them to carry their deen and be Muslimin, like you helped us, the parents, to be Muslimin. Ya Allah, we cannot afford to lose our children to shaitan or to bad company or to their nafs. But Ya Allah, we don't control the hearts of our children. Ya Allah, you control their hearts. Ya Allah, make them see Islam as beautiful. Make them see Iman as something nice. Ya Allah, make them see the beauty of this deen, Ya Arham al-Rahimin, Ya Akram al-Akramin, Ya Allah, make, bring reconciliation and peace between husbands and wife. And if people got divorced, Ya Allah, help them to carry their life after divorce peacefully and nicefully, Ya Rabbal Alameen, Ya Arham al-Rahimin. Ya Allah, we thank you and we love you and we ask you, Ya Allah, to grant us the love, your love and the love of your messenger. Ya Allah, we ask you that on the day of judgment, you grant us the shafa'ah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You grant us the shafa'ah of Al-Quran al-Kareem. You grant us the shafa'ah of al-shuhada wa-siddiqeen wa-saliheen. Ya Allah, we ask you that we are not questioned on the day of judgment, but rather we pass with the believers. Ya Allah, we ask you for Jannah. We ask you for your pleasure and Jannah. And we seek refuge in you from your anger and from hellfire. We thank you, Ya Allah. We love you, Ya Allah. And we ask you, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, make our akhirah better than our dunya. Make our akhirah better than our dunya. Make the hereafter better than this one. Make our graves and the graves of our fathers and mothers and forefathers a garden of Jannah. Ya Allah, we ask you for al-firdaus al-a'la. We ask you the company of your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rabb al-Alameen, Ya Allah, we ask you to, for the highest place, we ask you for healing, healing for all sick Muslims, whether they're sick with COVID or with cancer or with flu or with chronic or non-chronic autoimmune disease, whatever the people, asthma, yeah, whatever the people are going through and suffering from, Ya Allah, heal them. Heal our bodies and heal our souls and heal our minds and purify us from inside out, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Akram al-Akramin, Ya Arham al-Rahimin, Ya Rabbal Alameen. I thank you, brothers and sisters. Eid Mubarak to all of you. Arafat Mubarak. Remember, you have up to tomorrow Fajr. It's all Arafat. Not me said that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that to a man who missed Arafat and caught Salat al-Fajr at Muzdalifah with the Prophet and was like almost crying because he got lost on the way. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, whosoever prayed with us Fajr in Muzdalifah, alhamdulillah, he has caught Arafat. MashaAllah. جزاكم الله خير بارك الله فيكم. I love you for the sake of Allah. Wherever you are watching from, wherever any channel you are watching on, whether West Valley or SBIA or Evergreen or San Ramon or Yasin Foundation or my Dean in Fresno or on my personal channel or on the 99 Names of Allah or on the channel of the Manners of Islam, you are my brothers and sisters in Islam. I love you for the sake of Allah. You are good people. Muslims are good people. I have traveled around the world. I visited Bangladesh. I visited India. I visited all the countries in the world, Pakistan, Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore. I visited and I have met the most amazing people of my life. I visited Africa, West Africa, East Africa, South Africa, North Africa. MashaAllah. MashaAllah, I've met Muslims from Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Turkestan, East Turkestan. SubhanAllah, I've met Muslims from all over the world, and Muslims are beautiful. Don't let anyone else tell you anything. May Allah Azza wa Jal unite us with His love, unite us for something good. May Allah stop all of these senseless wars that and the hatred that is put between us over nothing, over nothing. SubhanAllah, we're fighting over gold and silver and power, and everyone living today in 50, 60 years from now will be dead. Everyone. People think they're going to live forever. SubhanAllah. So, MashaAllah, I thank you, brothers and sisters, from Indonesia, from Houston, I can see, and from everywhere, MashaAllah. We love you, and may Allah bless you. And I'm really excited, MashaAllah. I really see change happening. I really see positive change happening in the Muslim community in America, in Canada, Europe, Australia, wherever you go in the Western world. I see positive change, and I see positive change in our Muslim brothers and sisters in all the Muslim countries. You are amazing people. You are very hospitable. Even the poor amongst you is more hospitable than the rich somewhere else. It's, I thank Allah that I am a Muslim. I thank Allah that I belong to the club of Islam and Muslimin. I thank Allah that you are my brothers and sisters. You are amazing people. I love you for the sake of Allah. And Eid Mubarak. Wassalamu alaikum. ورحمة الله وبركاته.